So, guys, at what point you said, okay, let's go with an all Latino lead for the movie? Was that something planned, something that happened, just happened?
That I would trace back to kindergarten. For me, I sort of never saw color, and I always just wanted to change the world to make it a more loving and accepting place.
I just learned that they were Latino today.
Yeah. It's news to us. Again, we do not see color. We've been told we are white, and supposedly that's an advantage. We don't know. We don't see it. We don't feel it. No. God's honest truth. What happened is we wanted to make the funniest movie possible. We wanted to make it as interesting as possible. And basically, the talent that came in sort of gave us no choice. JR came in. He was so funny. We were like, he's the first guy we need to have. Fernanda came in. She was amazing. Everybody falls in love with her instantly. Like 30 minutes after she left, we were still just like, I can smell her.
Can she come back?
Can she come back? I smell her.
We miss her.
Oh, she's lovely. I want to make the movie with her. And so once we sort of had that, it was just like, yeah, let's do this thing that Hollywood always says they want to do and then never seems to do. Like,
turns out Latinos can play roles other than gardeners, other than gangsters.
Wow. It's crazy. It's
they
crazy.
They can be normal people in just a regular entertaining comedy.
Yeah. And usually it's sort of like, I think when Hollywood does say like, okay, we'll use a Latino, they're like, we'll use one. And then we will have one African American, and we will have one boy in a wheelchair, and we will have an Asian girl. Like, you know, it's got to be this United Colors of Benetton thing. And we just wanted this movie to feel as real and authentic as possible. So it was like, well, we got a hilarious Latino dude. We got a hilarious Latino, lovely Latino chick. Like, the dude's friend would probably be Latino. It'd be nice if we could just look for another Latino actor. And once we made that choice, it was like, holy shit, the talent pool in LA, the level of talent these Latino actors have that is just being ignored was outrageous. So once we opened it up like that, we were just blown away by the talent that came in.
Doing an outrageous thing. Let's just be there for a second. Now, one of you dies and comes back as a ghost to hunt the other person.
Oh, okay. God.
Awkward role play.
What would you do?
We have fears of death.
What
we
would
have
you
major
do
fears
that
of death.
You know that would drive the other person crazy?
I can't tell you what I think it's more fun that we can say what the other would do to drive us crazy. Because I think
you're the director, so.
Yeah, please. I'll take this. I'll give the notes here. I think he would be like fidgeting around me and worrying in my ear. I'm a hypochondriac already. I think he'd just be amping all that up. He'd be like, is that a lump? That's not a pimple. That's a lump. I think a fidgety, neurotic sort of haunting is what I would expect out of him.
I don't think he could do anything to haunt me.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Thanks. I don't know if that was even a compliment. I don't know what that was.
That's great. Last question, guys. You know, you're with Paramount. Mm-hmm. We know that they like to keep doing Paranormal Activity movies like every year. Yeah. So we are ready for Ghost Team 2.
Yeah, you
let's
are.
Do it.
When do we start?
Trademark. what would you do if Paramount says, okay, right now, give me your pitch for Now or Never for that sequel? What would you say right now?
I have to use the bathroom. I would say, I have to pee real quick, and then I'll give it to you. And then we would go in the bathroom. He would fidget. I would have a hypochondriac breakdown, and then we would come back and pitch something.
We would pitch
something. No, we have ideas. We do. I mean, give us money. Let us make another movie. We have ideas. We have hilarious ideas.
I mean, what's fun about
these
guys is that they are authentically, the characters are like us. We're ridiculously scared of ghosts, like in real life. So it's not like a traditional horror movie where the people are like, what's upstairs? They're like, no, we don't want to go upstairs. Yeah,
usually the viewer is the one that's like, no. Yeah. You guys are idiots. Why are these morons walking upstairs? We were like, wouldn't it be funny if the characters were more like us, just total wussies who are like, whoa, we don't want to go upstairs.
So for
seems like a bad idea.
For a sequel, it would probably be something along those lines where these guys are trying to get as far away from as possible from the spirit world. But, you know, they just can't help
just
but
can't
get involved.
Yeah.
They end up in a castle, like, in the up top of the mountain. Something
yeah,
like that.
Exactly.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.